Animation easing. How to use animation easing in Alight Motion. To add an easing to an animation, first you have to animate the property of a layer. Note, you can apply easings to any property that supports keyframes, including location, scale, rotation, color opacity, and all of the various effect parameters. I'll use location to demonstrate. To animate, we'll need at least two keyframes. Make sure the keyframes are solid white. If they appear faint, then you are in a different property. Switch back to the property where you added the keyframes. Bring the timeline in the middle of the two keyframes. Open the curve editor by tapping on it. This is the curve. You can customize it however you want to. There are some presets on the left. Linear ease in, ease out, ease in out. Try them out. This whole thing is kind of strange. I found this on one of Alight Motion's articles, but you can easily understand this by testing it out. I'll use this website to show you the curves to avoid unnecessary distractions. Notice how the box moves when you apply and test out a different curve? This one is an ease-out curve, which tends to start fast and slow down. Whilst this is an ease-in curve, which tends to start slow and then speed up. And the mixture of both, ease-in-out curve, which starts out fast, then goes through some linear time or moves in real time, and finally ends fast. We need to work like that too. Finally, the linear easing, which just moves. No speeding up, no slowing down, nothing. It just has linear time. Back to Alight Motion, if we tap on the overflow menu button, we can find four tools and options. Most of them are pretty self-explanatory. You can copy and paste the curve you made in the curve editor. Enable Overshoot allows you to make the curves go beyond the dotted lines box. By beyond, I mean that it can move the layer over the values you've set for the animation. When you enable overshoot, you can drag the curve handles beyond the dotted lines. You can disable overshoot the same way as you enabled it. This is the reverse curve button. Tapping it will flip or reverse your curve. Before we go talk about other advanced easing types, I'll let you know about easings on multiple keyframes. You can have as many keyframes as you want to, but the number of easing curves will also be exactly one less than the number of keyframes. That is because you can add one easing in one animation. To make one animation, you need to have two keyframes. Also, you can use these arrows to move between keyframes / easings. Advanced easing types. The easings that I've shown you previously are of the cubic bezier easing type. You can find the easing type at the bottom. Other than the cubic bezier, we also have bounce, elastic, cyclic, random steps, and elastic steps. Note, every other easing type other than cubic bezier requires premium. Drag the handles up or down to adjust the bounciness and left or right to adjust the speed of the bounce. Drag this handle up or down to adjust the elasticity. And drag it left or right to adjust the speed and the number of cycles. This is the damping handle. You can drag it up or down to control the overshoot of the easing. Drag the handle to change between linear and smooth easing for each cycle. The frequency handle controls the number of cycles and the damping handle does this thing. You can drag the bias handle to make these geometrical triangles, which adds a teleportation-like effect. Drag the handles up or down for the magnitude and left to right for the frequency of randomness. And these other handles are also for adjusting the easing. You can use the seat handle to tune the pattern of randomness. This easing is kind of similar to the time quantization effect. Drag left or right to control the number of steps. Drag the easing handle left or right to control if the steps pop out of nowhere or if it has a smooth easing to it. Drag left or right to adjust the number of steps, and drag the easing handle to adjust the elasticity. That's all the easing types. It is up to you to use it how you want to.